Hello dear students, welcome to the accountancy class. What is our today's class topic? Today onwards we are going to start solving our textbook sums. Textbook that we may yes to numerical questions kottaru. Now adashtu avaru solve madaka prayatna madavaru divrodi. Nimaga syllabus dagi yenen aiti pattadage. Everything has been covered. All the journal entries, all the theory aspects, all the adjustment entries, everything has been taught to you. And along with that only, we have taken not less than 20 to 30 sums also. Okay, from numerical questions as well as from the examples that I took during my video classes itself. Okay, so roughly 30 questions have been solved, and yet 10 questions I will solve from your textbook. Textbook daginda na nimu 10 questions solve maad kodtini. So almost every type of question is being covered. Okay. क्वेश्चन बैंक बिड़स कंपलसरी ऐति सो आफ्टर सॉल्विंग दिस मेनी सम्स यू शुड एंड मस्ट बी एबल टू सॉल्व दीज क्वेश्चन वेरी प्रॉपरली नाउ व्हाट वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट फ्रॉम टुडे ऑनवर्ड्स वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट युअर न्यूमेरिकल क्वेश्चन ओके व्हाट टेक्स्ट बुक इज देयर ऑफ युअर्स अकाउंटेंसी फ्रॉम दैट वी आर टेकिंग द न्यूमेरिकल क्वेश्चन इन दैट वी आर गोइंग टू टेक टुडे द सोल्यूशन फॉर क्वेश्चन नंबर 12. Okay, so what is question number 12? Let us understand. So for that purpose, I have already prepared a journal book. See, it's very very important to read the question, understand the question, and then only start solving the question. What they are saying is, Krishna Limited issued 15,000 shares of rupees 100 each at a premium of rupees 10 per share. Now see here my dear children, in the last question also we have taken one question on premium. This is also a question on premium itself, but there is a difference between that question and this question. So when you are studying this question, kindly compare with that question also, that what is the major difference. At the end of the sum, at the end of this sum, I will tell you what was the difference. See, so here Krishna Limited issued 15,000 shares of rupees 100 each at a premium of rupees 10 per share, payable as follows: rupees 30 on application, rupees 50 on allotment, including the premium, and first and final call of rupees 30. Now all the shares were subscribed, and the company received all the money due, with the exception of the allotment and call money of 150 shares. These shares were forfeited and reissued to Neha as fully paid of rupees 120 each. Nim textbook dalli adu 100 rupay agit nodri. Dayabittu adu 120 madri. There's a slight printing mistake over there. So they have printed as rupees 12. You have to make it as rupees 120 each. Give journal entries in the books of the company. Very very easy question. Madantro idu question ige sariyagi tumkori nodri. ಏನ್ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೋ 100 ರುಪೀಸ್ ದ ಶೇರ್ ಗೆ 110 ರುಪೀಸ್ ದಲ್ಲಿ ಅವ್ರು ಏನ್ ಮಾಡಕತ್ತಾರೋ ಇಶ್ಯೂ ಮಾಡಕತ್ತಾರೋ. ಐ ಆಮ್ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಶೋಯಿಂಗ್ ದ ರಫ್ ವರ್ಕ್ ಹಿಯರ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಸಿ ಹಿಯರ್, ಆಫ್ 100 ರುಪೀಸ್ ಶೇರ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಇಶ್ಯೂಯಿಂಗ್ ಇಟ್ ಅಟ್ 110. ಸೊ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ರಾ 10 ರುಪೀಸ್. ವಾಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಪ್ರೀಮಿಯಂ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ. ಓಕೆ, ಯಾವಾಗ ಯಾವ್ದಾರ ಒಂದು ಕಂಪನಿ ಇದೆ ಮಾರ್ಕೆಟ್ ಸಿಚುವೇಶನ್ ಒಳ್ಳೇದಿರ್ತೈತಿ, ದೇ ಆರ್ ಡೂಯಿಂಗ್ ಗುಡ್, they are giving more dividend, they are earning more profits, and their financial position is good, ultimately the share value of that company will go on increasing. Okay, and then when the share value increases, then the face value, ultimately that extra amount is called as premium. And in accountancy, whatever economic event is there, it has to be recorded. So increase in the value of the face value is an economic event, and hence it has to be recorded. So illi, what is the name of the company? See, it is Krishna Limited. How they are going to collect this 110 rupees? This 110 rupees, they are collecting rupees 30 on application, rupees 50 on allotment, and rupees 30 on first and final call. So if you can make the total, see the total is coming for 110. But what is the face value? It is rupees 100. So where this 10 rupees is being charged here? So 40 plus 10. So 40 is the face value and 10 is the premium. Why is it necessary to divide this 50 rupees into the face value and allotment? It is compulsory. See, ಇದನ್ನು ಡಿವೈಡ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಸೆಪರೇಟ್ ಆಗಿನ ತೋರಿಸಬೇಕು ವೆದರ್ ಇಟ್ ಮೇ ಬಿ ಡಿಸ್ಕೌಂಟ್ ಆರ್ ವೆದರ್ ಇಟ್ ಮೇ ಬಿ ಅ ಪ್ರೀಮಿಯಂ ಓಕೆ ಸೊ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಡಿಸ್ಕೌಂಟ್ ಇರ್ತಿತ್ತಂದ್ರೆ ನೀವು ಮೈನಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಿದ್ರಿ ಬಟ್ ಆಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅ ಪ್ರೀಮಿಯಂ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಪ್ಲಸ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಶೋ ಇನ್ ಟು ದ ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ದ ಫೇಸ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ That is why this division is compulsory. Okay, and whatever excess or deficit is there, suppose a discount mal issue madirandra, adu discount on issue of shares account dalli torisbeku. Premium mal issue madagatirandra, adu securities premium account dalli torisbeku. Hangagi yen nimde jaasti athwa kadime amount agakateyte, adannu compulsorily separate agina torisbeku. Okay, so illi tanaka namage lekka tilidaiti. ಏನ್ ಹೇಳ್ಯಾರ ನೋಡ್ರಿ 30 ರೂಪಾಯಿ ಅಪ್ಲಿಕೇಶನ್ ಮೇಲೆ 50 ರೂಪಾಯಿ ಅಲಾಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಮೇಲೆ ಅದರ ಜೊತೆಯಲ್ಲಿನ ಏನ್ ಸೇರ್ಕೊಂಡೈತಿ ಪ್ರೀಮಿಯಂ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಅನ್ನು ಸೇರ್ಕೊಂಡೈತಿ ಮೊದಲನೇದು ಮತ್ತೆ ಕೊನೆಯ ಕಾಲ್ ಎಷ್ಟು ರುಪೀಸ್ ಇದೈತಿ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ರುಪೀಸ್ 30 ಸೊ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ವೇ ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಲಿಮಿಟೆಡ್ ಇಸ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಕಲೆಕ್ಟ್ 110 ರುಪೀಸ್ ಆನ್ 15,000 ಶೇರ್ಸ್ ನೌ ಹಿಯರ್ ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಅಡ್ಜಸ್ಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ವಾಟ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಸೇಯಿಂಗ್ ಸಿ ಒನ್ ಶೇರ್ ಹೋಲ್ಡರ್ ಹೂ ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ 150 ಶೇರ್ಸ್ couldn't pay right from the allotment itself okay so a shareholder who is holding 150 shares he was unable to pay the allotment money as well as the first and final call now here the sum is on forfeiture and reissue where the allotment money itself is not received whereas in the previous question the premium amount was received and later on they were unable to pay the first and final call and the reissue entries were done this is the major difference okay so basically in reissue how many types of questions you are seeing four types kindly go for day 17 and see the theory class for the reissue of the forfeited shares it's a very very important class I have kept that class for 20 minutes or 27 minutes only I have not added any question in that so that you should see it properly lengthy aguna ki majority students end tanka nodakattilla so for that purpose only I have kept that class short and very informative so if whenever you are solving these sums go again and again and watch day number 17 it will make you perfect okay so here ili tanka telitu how many journal entries will come 6 journal entries will come application received application transfer allotment money due allotment money received along with the arrears first and final call due first and final call received along with the arrears correct now what is the adjustment that they are telling that all the shares subscribed and the company received all money due with the exception for the allotment and call money on 150 shares these shares were forfeited so here first entry will come for the forfeiture and reissued to Neha as a fully paid share of rupees 120 each so here what is important see reissue maadbekadru avadu premium mellena reissue aagaitu okay so again how many entries will come two entries first for the reissue and later on whatever balance is remaining on the share forfeiture account that needs to be transferred so all together how many entries will come only 9 journal entries will come 3 for 6 for this one for the forfeiture one for the reissue and the last one will be for the balance on share forfeiture transferred to capital reserve okay so very easy question examiner hinta questions na kelthaaru whatever we are studying from today like this questions only will come into your exams okay so all of you let us start solving the sums first journal entry for the application money received so write down bank account debit 2 what kind of shares these are have they mentioned okay they haven't mentioned anywhere so we'll write down simply share application account into bracket show the calculation how many shares 15,000 shares what is the amount it is rupees 30 each okay so therefore what is the amount see it is equal to rupees how many zeros four zeros 4,50,000, 4,50,000. Write down the narration. B, application money. B, application money received. B, application money received on 15,000 shares at ₹30 each. Okay, bracket complete and draw one line. Immediately, what will be your next journal entry for transferring? So transfer madbekadre illi nimge en credit aithi adu debit aagide. So write down share application account debit. Two, what share capital account? ಇದೆಲ್ಲ ದುಡ್ಡು ಎಲ್ಲಿ ಹೋಗಿ ಜಮಾ ಆಗ್ಬೇಕು ನೋಡ್ರಿ, ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲ್ ಅಕೌಂಟ್ ನಲ್ಲಿ ಜಮಾ ಆಗ್ಬೇಕು. ಅಂಡ್ ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಅಮೌಂಟ್? ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಇಸ್ ರುಪೀಸ್ 4,50,000. ಇಂಟು ಬ್ರಾಕೆಟ್ ಗಿವ್ ದ ನ್ಯಾರೇಷನ್. ಬೀಂಗ್ ಅಪ್ಲಿಕೇಶನ್ ಮನಿ, ಬೀಂಗ್ ಅಪ್ಲಿಕೇಶನ್ ಮನಿ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಫರ್ to capital account, transferred to capital account. Okay, so very easy. First two journal entries, application money received, application money transferred. Now let us go for our third journal entry. What it is? Allotment money due. Okay, so see, I am telling this again and again, again and again into my each question answer. ಎಷ್ಟು ಸಲ ನಾನು ರಿಪೀಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೇನೆ ಸಬ್ ಕಾನ್ಶಿಯಸ್ ಮೈಂಡ್ ದಾಗ ನಿಮಗ ಅದ ನೆನಪಾಗ್ಬಿಡ್ತೈತಿ. ಅದಕ್ಕಾಗಿ ನಾ ಬರೇ ಬರೀ ಇವೆಲ್ಲ ಮಾತ್ರ ನಿಮಗೆ ಹೇಳ್ತಿರ್ತೀನಿ ನೋಡ್ರಿ. ಇದು ಮೊದಲನೇ ಸಂದರ್ಭ ಅಷ್ಟ ಐತಿ ಎಲ್ಲಿ ನಿಮಗ್ ಬೇಡ್ಲಾರ್ದ ದುಡ್ಡು ಸಿಗ್ತೈತಿ, ಎಲ್ಲಿ ಅಪ್ಲಿಕೇಶನ್ ಮನಿದಾಗ. ಅದ ಆದ ನಂತರ ಪ್ರತಿ ಒಂದು ಸಂದರ್ಭದಲ್ಲಿ ಅದ ಅಲಾಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಇರ್ಲಿ, ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಕಾಲ್ ಇರ್ಲಿ, ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಕಾಲ್ ಇರ್ಲಿ, ಕೊನೆಯ ಕಾಲ್ ಇರ್ಲಿ, ಈಚ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಡಿಮಾಂಡ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದೆನ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ದ ಶೇರ್ ಹೋಲ್ಡರ್ಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಪೇ. So in the first journal entry only directly the amount is received and later on it is transferred into your capital account. But after that each time you have to demand, that is the money will be due and later on it will be received. Okay, so yes, let us do the entry. Share allotment account debit. Share allotment account debit. Now please remember here that there is a share premium also. Okay, so show the calculation over here. How many shares are there? 15,000 shares are there. Okay, now on these 15,000 shares, how much money is demanded? See, it is ₹50 per share. Out of this ₹50, how much will go to the capital account? Only the face value. Okay, so two share capital account into bracket 15,000 shares into ₹40 each, bracket complete. Two securities premium account, two securities premium account into bracket 15,000 shares into ₹10 each. Okay, now let us see how the amounts are coming. See, 15,000 into 10, so the securities premium account will have ₹1,50,000. What about the share capital? So the share capital will have ₹6,00,000 and the total is for share allotment account, so which is equal to ₹7,50,000. ಓಕೆ, ಈಗ ನೀವು ನನಗೆ ಕೇಳಬಹುದು, ಮೇಡಮ್ ಇದು ಬೈಫರ್ಕೇಶನ್ ಮಾಡುವುದು ಕಂಪಲ್ಸರಿ ಐತಿ? ಎಸ್, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಂಪಲ್ಸರಿ. ಯಾಕಂದ್ರೆ ನಿಮ್ ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲ್ ಅಕೌಂಟ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಬರೇ ಅದ್ರ ಏನ್ ಫೇಸ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಐತಿ ಅಷ್ಟೇ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಜಮಾ ಆಗ್ತೈತಿ. ಓಕೆ, ಈಗ ಈ ಶೇರ್ಸ್ ಇಶ್ಯೂ ಮಾಡಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ನಿಮಗ್ ಲಾಭ ಆಗೈತಿ ನುಕ್ಸಾನ್ ಆಗೈತಿ ಅದನ್ನ ನೀವು ಸಪರೇಟ್ ಆಗಿ ನ ತೋರಿಸಬೇಕು. ಸೊ ಈ ಸಂದರ್ಭದಲ್ಲಿ ಈ ಲೆಕ್ಕದಲ್ಲಿ ಏನಾಗೈತಿ, ದ ಶೇರ್ಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಬಿನ್ ಇಶ್ಯೂಡ್ ಅಟ್ ಅ ಪ್ರೀಮಿಯಂ. So there the company has a capital gain. Okay, it's not just a regular income, it's a capital gain, and that extra money that the company has earned due to its hard work, its goodwill or its good performance, that capital gain should be shown separately into a separate account, which is called as securities premium account. Okay, because in future there will be taxations and all these things. Okay, idella mundu bhavishyada sambandhapattide iri. Innond mathu ba clear cut tilkondu bidri, my dear students. You are not just studying for marks or degree. Okay, tomorrow you will be doing a corporate job. Multinational companies nalli higher position mellu job tagotiru. ಅವಾಗ ನಿಮ್ ಕಡೆ ಎಲ್ಲಾನು ಐತಿ, ಪರ್ಸನಾಲಿಟಿ ಐತಿ, ಕಮ್ಯುನಿಕೇಶನ್ ಐತಿ, ಆಟಿಟ್ಯೂಡ್ ಐತಿ, ಎಲ್ಲಾನು ಐತಿ. ಇದು ಖಾಲಿ ಐತಂದ್ರೆ ಯಾರು ಬಿಟ್ಕೊಳಂಗಿಲ್ಲ ನಿಮಗೆ. ಅದು ಎಲ್ಲ ಬ್ಯಾಕಿದೇನೂ ಇಲ್ಲ, ಬಟ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ದ ಬ್ರೈನ್ಸ್ ದಟ್ ಆಲ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಗೆಟ್ ಲೆಟರ್ ಆನ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ. ಆಟಿಟ್ಯೂಡ್, ಸ್ಟೈಲ್, ಪರ್ಸನಾಲಿಟಿ, ಕಮ್ಯುನಿಕೇಶನ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಕಮ್ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ವರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ. ಬಟ್ ನಾಲೆಜ್ ಯು ವಿಲ್ ಗೆಟ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಅಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಏಜ್ ವೆನ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ಯುವರ್ ಕಾಲೇಜ್. ಓಕೆ, ನಾನು ನಿಮಗೆ ಆಕ್ಚುಲಿ ಹೇಳಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ಎಷ್ಟಕ್ಕೊಂದು ಆನ್ಲೈನ್ ಕಾರ್ಪೊರೇಟ್ ಕಾಂಪಿಟೇಷನ್ಸ್ ನಡೀತಾವೆ ಪಿ ಯು ಸಿ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಇಯರ್ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಸಲುವಾಗಿ ಈ ವಿಷಯದ ಮೇಲೆ, ಆನ್ ಯುವರ್ ಅಕೌಂಟಿಂಗ್ ಆಫ್ ಶೇರ್ ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲ್. ಓಕೆ, ಎಷ್ಟಕ್ಕೊಂದು ಸರ್ಟಿಫಿಕೇಟ್ಸ್ ಇರ್ತಾವೆ ಇದ್ರ ಸಲುವಾಗಿ. ಬಟ್ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಸ್ಟಡಿಯಿಂಗ್ ಇನ್ ಆನ್ಲೈನ್ ಮೋಡ್, ಇದ ನಿಮಗೆ ಪರ್ಫೆಕ್ಟ್ ಆಗಿ ಬರಾಕತ್ತೋ ಇಲ್ಲ ಐ ಆಮ್ ನಾಟ್ ಶೋರ್. ಸೊ ಫಾರ್ಗೆಟ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದೋಸ್ ಅದರ್ ಕಾಂಪಿಟೇಟಿವ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಮ್ಸ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ. Okay, so you all people please realize the time and value that you have right now. Do not forget the other professional courses. CA, CS, nimda aim aitandra, please focus on that also. You have to simultaneously study for that also. Okay, time is not coming, time is going and it will never come back. So you have to utilize the time that you have properly. Okay. ಸೊ ಇದಕ್ಕೆ ನಾವು ಏನ್ ಕೊಟ್ಬಿಡೋನು, ನ್ಯಾರೇಷನ್ ಕೊಟ್ಬಿಡೋನು. ನ್ಯಾರೇಷನ್ ನ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಬರೆದು ಬಿಡ್ತೇನೆ, ರೈಟ್ ಡೌನ್. ಬೀಯಿಂಗ್ ಅಲಾಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಮನಿ ಡ್ಯೂ, ಬೀಯಿಂಗ್ ಅಲಾಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಮನಿ ಡ್ಯೂ ಆನ್ 15,000 shares ಅಟ್ ದ ರೇಟ್ ಅಟ್ ರುಪೀಸ್ ಹೌ ಮಚ್ ಸಿ 50 ಈಚ್, at rupees 50 each along with premium. Okay, so what is the NPC? Allotment money received. Now what we have to write down? Allotment money received. Please tell me, is the allotment duly received? The answer is no. 150 shares yaar kade agavu avra doddu vannu tumlikke agilla. Okay, so write down journal entry number 4 for allotment money received. So write down bank account debit into bracket out of 15,000 shares on how much the amount is not received, 150. So on how much it is received then? 14,850 shares into rupees 50 each. So obviously what are there? Calls in arrears are there. Calls in arrears account into bracket 150 shares into rupees 50 each. 2. Yadar mele the amount due in notary on your share allotment. So write down 2. Share allotment account. Okay, so what is the amount C that was demanded? 7,50,000 was demanded. Have you received that 7,50,000 completely? No. A shareholder who was holding 150 shares couldn't pay that amount. So calculator and tell me, what is the amount that is not received? 00 has it is. 5 are 25. 2 will become carry. 5 is a 5. So 7,500 money. Amount is not received. So obviously the rest is received. Okay, so 7,42,500 is the amount that is received. How much was demanded? 7,50,000 was demanded. Give the narration being allotment money received. Allotment money received except on 150 shares. Okay, Now this is done. What is the next journal entry for the first and final call due? So show share first and final call account debit, share first and final call account debit, into bracket show the calculations, 15,000 shares into rupees. What is the amount that is demanded? See, it is rupees 30 per share. Okay, now where this amount will be credited to? Share capital account. Okay, so tell me, what is the amount that is due or demanded? It is 4,50,000. Give the narration. Being first and final call due. First and final call due. Okay. Now again, is the all amount that is due is received? The answer is no. Okay. As it is given into the question that a shareholder was unable to pay the allotment and call money. So again, there are calls in arrears. So bank account debit into bracket. Again, on how many shares the amount is not received? Same, 150 shares. So then how many it has been received? It has been received on 14,850 shares at the rate of rupees 30 each. At the rate of rupees 30 each. Okay. So now tell me, what is the calls in arrears? The calls in arrears is for 150 shares into rupees 30 each. Correct? Two, for what this amount has been demanded for share first and final call. So write down, two, share first and final call account. Okay? So then, what is the amount that was due? 4,50,000 was due. How much is not received? See, 150 into 30 is equal to 4,500 is not received. So obviously the rest has been received. Okay, so 4,45,500 rupee has been received. Okay, give the narration. Being first and final call received. First and final call received, except on 150 shares. Except on 150 shares. So notary, in UEN are journal entries made. You basic journal entries are. Okay, what are those? See, application money received, application money transferred. Allotment due, allotment received. Okay, then share first and final call due, first and final call received. Okay, now what remaining three entries are going to come? They all three are related to the forfeiture. What is the next entry that we are going to do? The cancellation of the shares on which the amount is not being received. Later on, the same forfeited shares will be reissued. And at the end of the reissue, if there is any balance on the share forfeiture, it needs to be transferred to the capital reserve. So that three journal entries are fixed into each and every question. Okay, so let us go for that. So here we are going to do entry number 7 for the forfeiture of shares. Okay. Okay, so yes, let us go for the entry number 7. What it is for the cancellation of these 150 shares, where they have told, see, these shares were forfeited. Okay, so for the first time we will put share capital account a debit for how many shares? For 150 shares into rupees. Please, dear children, remember only the face value needs to be taken. So what is the face value here? It is rupees 100 per share. So therefore, what is the amount? See, it is 15,000. Now please remember, here the shareholder was unable to pay even the securities premium. Already you have credited securities premium in your entry number 3. ಈಗ ಯಾವಾಗ ದುಡ್ಡು ಬಂದೇ ಇಲ್ಲ ಅವಾಗ ನೀವು ಅದನ್ನ ಹೆಂಗ್ ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲ್ ಗೇನ್ ಅಂತ ತೋರಿಸಬಹುದು. ಸೊ ಯಾವಾಗ ನಿಮಗೆ ಲಾಭ ಆಗೇ ಇಲ್ಲ ಅದನ್ನ ನೀವು ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕಾಗ್ತೈತಿ? ಕ್ಯಾನ್ಸಲ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕಾಗ್ತೈತಿ. ಸೊ ಹಿಯರ್ ಸೆಕ್ಯೂರಿಟೀಸ್ ಪ್ರೀಮಿಯಂ ಅಕೌಂಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಡೆಬಿಟೆಡ್. ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ದ ಪ್ರೀಮಿಯಂ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಇಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ರಿಸೀವ್ಡ್. If the premium amount would have been received, we would have not debited the securities premium account over here. Okay, so how much we are going to cancel on 150 shares into rupees 10 per share? So how much it will become? See, it will become rupees 1500. Correct. Now, two share for future account or for future share account, whatever you can write. Share for future account. In this account, what you will show? The amount that has been totally received from this particular shares. So on 150 shares, you note the related dali. Matra avaru application mali ashta tumbyaru. Allotment nu tumbilla, first and final call nu tumbilla. So what was the amount that was paid? It was merely 30 rupees of application. So on 150 shares, 30 rupees each has been paid, which is equal to rupees 4,500. Now here, my dear children, what we will show? The call scenarios. So if you can see entry number 4 and entry number 6, how we are going to take call scenarios? See, on entry number 4, there is a call scenarios of rupees 7,500. That is allotment with the premium. Plus 4,500 for first and final call. You have to take that complete call scenario. So total call scenario that will become rupees 12,000. Compulsorily your debit and credit should tally. Then only your journal entry is correct. Dual aspect concept is aadhar mele na accountancy based rahi. So you can see here it is 16,500 and here also it is 16,500. ಓಕೆ, ನಾ ಮತ್ತೊಮ್ಮೆ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೇನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀನಿ ನೋಡ್ರಿ. ನಾ ಇದು ಏನು ಎಂಟ್ರಿ ಮಾಡೇನಿ, ಮೊದಲನೇದಾದ್ರೂ ನಾ ಶೇರ್ ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲ್ ಅಕೌಂಟಿಗೆ ಡೆಬಿಟ್ ಕೊಡಾಕತ್ತೇನಿ. ವೈ? ವಿ ಆರ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ಸಲಿಂಗ್ ದ ಶೇರ್ಸ್ ದಟ್ ದೇ ವರ್ ಅಲಾಟೆಡ್. ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಫಾರ್ ಫ್ಯೂಚರ್ ಆಫ್ ಶೇರ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ಹೌ ಮೆನಿ ಶೇರ್ಸ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ಸಲಿಂಗ್? 150 ಶೇರ್ಸ್. ವೈ? ಡ್ಯೂ ಟು ದ ನಾನ್ ಪೇಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಅಲಾಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಫೈನಲ್ ಕಾಲ್. ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಫೇಸ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಪರ್ ಶೇರ್? ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ರುಪೀಸ್ 100 ಪರ್ ಶೇರ್. ಸೊ ಟೋಟಲಿ ಹೌ ಮಚ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಬಿನ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ಸಲ್? 15,000. Now in this case, in this question, even the premium is also not paid. Hence, the securities premium account also is being debited by the number of shares that are being cancelled, not by all shares. So on 150 shares, rupees 10 per share has not been received. And therefore, the securities premium account is debited by 1,500 rupees. Now what will be credited here? First of all, we will credit the share for future account. What is this account? This is an account in which the amount that has been received so far on the shares that has been forfeited, that amount will be shown here. So on 150 shares which are being forfeited, 30 rupees have been received in the form of application. So that money is transferred here into the share for future account. And the amount which is due, which is not received, which was shown as calls in arrears, will be credited here. So on the allotment, 7,500 was not received and on first and final call 4500 was not received. So total amount how much is not received on this 150 shares? It is rupees 12,000. You can calculate it in another way also. You can take 150 shares into rupees 80 each. That is your allotment plus first call. You will get the same digit. Okay? So yes, for this only we need to write down a narration. Bahashtu students, ye narration barbekadre baha trasayit nodri. Narration is very very important. If you do not write the narration properly, you will lose your half mark. So understand the technique of writing a narration. It has to be simple and it has to be short, but it has to be completely understandable. It has to be a brief explanation of your journal entry. So write down, being 150 shares forfeited, that's it. Being 150 shares forfeited. Or if you want, you can give still detailed narration. For non-payment of allotment money with premium and first and final call. Okay, so this will give you complete idea of what and how the journal entry has come. So what is this journal entry all about? It is all about the cancellation, that is forfeiture. See, in my video classes, I have given you so beautifully the notes. I have taught you first forfeiture. On that we have practiced the sums. Later on, I have taught you the reissue of forfeited shares. Okay? So kindly go through the classes daily. Then only you will become an expert into accountancy. And accountancy is a compulsory subject for every business. No business can function on this planet without accountancy. So if you are into commerce, ultimately accountancy should and must be your advantageous subject. You cannot keep it into option. You cannot score in this subject less than 90, anyone of you. But a topper sashta alla, each one of you should be above 90 in this subject. Because this is the core of commerce. Understand this. Okay. So next. What is the next entry? Reissue. So yavagi 150 shares ki cancel madiri, forfeit madiri, company yen decide madabodu adu mattomme market alli issue madodu decision tagobodu matte illi tagondar nodri yen helagutaru reissue to neha irli, smita irli, ramesh, suresh, yar bekkadavar irli, the name of the shareholder will be not written into your journal entry. Yes, if you want, you can write it down into your narration. Correct? So, ili en helutaru neha avrige 120 rupay prakara mattomme reissue madaru. Nim textbook dalli 12 anta bandaiti. Adu printing mistake agaiti. Dayabittu adu 120 anta maadkoru. So, the forfeited shares have been reissued again at a premium. So, when you reissue, what you will get? You will get money. So, bank account debit. Show the calculation. How many shares? 150 shares into rupees 120 per share. Should I write 120? Yes, I should write 120 per share. Now please remember, yavag now reissue maartivi, almost it will be a lump sum payment. One shot dalli na payment irtaiti, application, allotment, first call, final call, hang hantadalli tugangilla idu madalena. ಎರಡನೇ ಮಂತ್ ಬ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯಾವಾಗ ದುಡ್ಡು ತಗೋತೈತಿ, ಇದು ಫೇಸ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಐತಿ, ಇದು ಪ್ರೀಮಿಯಂ ಐತಿ, ಹಂಗ್ ಭಾಗ ಮಾಡಿ ತಗೋಂಗಿಲ್ಲ, ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಎಟ್ ಬರ್ತೈತಿ ಟೋಟಲಿ ತಗೊಂಡ್ ಬಿಡ್ತೈತಿ. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ದ ಬ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ರಿಸೀವ್ 120 ರುಪೀಸ್ ಆನ್ 150 ಶೇರ್ಸ್. ವಿ ಶುಡ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಬೈಫರ್ಕೇಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ದ ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಸೆಕ್ಯೂರಿಟೀಸ್ ಪ್ರೀಮಿಯಂ. ಸೊ ಇಕ್ವಿಟಿ ಶೇರ್ ಇಲ್ಲ, ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಶೇರ್ ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲ್. So into bracket 150 shares into rupees 100 each. What is this 100? It is the face value. 2 securities premium. Okay. So that is 150 shares into rupees 20 each. So prati one share ye mattomme issue maadbekadre ivrige laabh agaitu nodri. There is no loss on reissue and hence ee entry dalli neevu nortiri ellu share for future barakattilla. So illi nim share for future dalli en 4500 rupay jama agide, it's a complete profit for the company. Okay, so let us find out the amounts. 150 shares into 20 each, which is equal to rupees 3000. Okay, this is equal to rupees 15000. And what is the total amount that has been received by the bank? It is rupees 18000. Okay, narration barisbitri being reissued. This word is very important. You cannot say issued. You have to use the word reissued. Being reissued, the forfeited shares at a premium. Okay, so what forfeited shares are there? You have reissued them at a premium. Okay, now let us do the last journal entry, that is whatever balance you have into your share for future account, that needs to be transferred to capital reserve. Shabdadalli na yen bandidu nodri, transfer. So illi share for future ge yen kottiri, debit kottiri, sorry credit kottiri. Transfer agbekadre adu yen aagibidteki, debit aagibidte. So debit kottibidri adakka, share for future account debit to capital reserve account. Capital reserve account. ಈಗ ನೋಡ್ರಿ ಶಾರ್ಟ್ ಶಾರ್ಟ್ ನಿಮಗೆ ಏನಾಗ್ಬಿಟ್ಟೈತಿ 4500 ರುಪೀಸ್ ಅದ ಪ್ರಾಫಿಟ್ ಆಗಿಬಿಟ್ಟೈತಿ. ಸೊ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ಲಿ 4500 ನೀವು ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀರಿ, ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಫರ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು. ಗಿವ್ ದ ನ್ಯಾರೇಷನ್. ಬೀಂಗ್ ಬ್ಯಾಲೆನ್ಸ್ ಆನ್ ಶೇರ್ ಫಾರ್ ಫ್ಯೂಚರ್ ಅಕೌಂಟ್, being balance on share for future account, transferred to capital reserve account. Capital reserve account. Okay, so with this the question comes to an end. What kind of questions we are solving? These are the questions which will come into your annual exams. Okay, so focus. Now here I have completed question number 12. I will teach in this class itself the question number 13 also. So stay tuned. As you can see on the board, what I have done, see, we are preparing the journal entries in the books of Arushi Computers Limited. Now what is this question? Question number 13 from your textbook page number 69. Okay, what we are doing, we are solving the numerical questions that have been given into your textbook. Okay, so first let us read and understand the question. Yen helthar nodre, Arushi Computers Limited issued 10,000 equity shares of rupees 100 each at a discount of 10%. So new notary madalne sathe discount mel iruvanta lekka thugagathiri, where the shares will be forfeited and reissued. Once when I finish this question, all the types of questions have been covered of your syllabus. What remains after this question is only the practice. And only the practice makes an accountant perfect. So if you want to become perfect, you want to make sure your accountancy subject is clean and clear, and you are very much having the knowledge of accountancy, daily you have to solve whatever work is being given to you, then only you will score good marks. November is at the end. According to me, you should put a deadline for yourself of 100 days. 100 days from now, anytime the government can announce your annual exam. So in 100 days you have to complete your 6 subjects with full syllabus. Understand the countdown which is going on now. Okay, so realize the importance, wake up, start studying seriously. Okay, so yes, let us start. ಏನು ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ ನೋಡ್ರಿ, ಆರುಷಿ ಕಂಪ್ಯೂಟರ್ಸ್ ಲಿಮಿಟೆಡ್ ಅವರು 10,000 ಇಕ್ವಿಟಿ ಶೇರ್ಸ್ ಗಳನ್ನು ಮಾರ್ಕೆಟ್ ದಲ್ಲಿ 100 ರೂಪಾಯಿ ಇರುವಂತ ಶೇರ್ಸ್ ಗೆ 10% ರಿಯಾಯಿತಿ ದಲ್ಲಿ ಡಿಸ್ಕೌಂಟ್ ದಲ್ಲಿ ಇಶ್ಯೂ ಮಾಡಕತ್ತ. ದ ನೆಟ್ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಪೇಬಲ್ ಆರ್ ಆಸ್ ಫಾಲೋಸ್. ಸೊ ನೋಡ್ರಿ, ಇದು ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲನೇಷನ್ ಬಹಳ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಇರ್ತೈತಿ. 100 ರೂಪೀಸ್ ಶೇರ್ ಈಸ್ ಇಶ್ಯೂಡ್ ಅಟ್ ಎ ಡಿಸ್ಕೌಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ 10%. ಸೊ 10% ತೆಗೆದಿದ್ದಾಗ 1-0 ತೆಗೆದು ಬಿಡ್ರಿ. What is the discount amount? It is rupees 10. So at what price the shares are being issued into the market? At rupees 90. Yav reethi nimge dudu collect madavallada nodri. It is into 4 installments. Rupees 20 on application, rupees 30 on allotment, rupees 30 on first call, and rupees 10 on final call. So you can see the total is becoming 90. But as it is told that whatever economic event is happening, it has to be recorded into your books of accounts. New shares ige at par issue madri, at premium issue madri, athwa at discount issue madri, whatever the economic event may be, it has to be recorded. Illi new 100 rupees share 90 rupees issue madakathirandra, there is a capital loss of rupees 10. ಇದನ್ನ ನೀವು ಕಂಪಲ್ಸರಿಲಿ ನಿಮ್ ಪುಸ್ತಕದಲ್ಲಿ ತೋರಿಸಬೇಕು. ಸೊ ಹಿಯರ್ ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಕ್ಲಿಯರ್ಲಿ ಮೆನ್ಷನ್ ದಟ್ ದ ಅಲಾಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಶುಡ್ ಬಿ ಕನ್ಸಿಡರ್ಡ್ ಆಫ್ ರುಪೀಸ್ 40 ಮೈನಸ್ 10 ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು 30 ರುಪೀಸ್. ಸೊ ವೆನ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಮೇಕಿಂಗ್ ದ ಜರ್ನಲ್ ಎಂಟ್ರಿ ಫಾರ್ ದ ಅಲಾಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಮನಿ ಡ್ಯೂ, ದಟ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಇಟ್ ಸೆಲ್ಫ್ ಯು ಶುಡ್ ಶೋ ದ ಇಫೆಕ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಡಿಸ್ಕೌಂಟ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ. ಪ್ಲೀಸ್ ರಿಮೆಂಬರ್ ದಿಸ್. ಸಪೋಸ್ ಲೆಕ್ಕದಾಗ ಏನು ಮಾಹಿತಿ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿಲ್ಲ, ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ನೋ ಇನ್ಫಾರ್ಮೇಶನ್ ಗಿವನ್ ರೈಟ್ ನೌ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್, ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟೋಲ್ಡ್ ಅಸ್ ಕ್ಲಿಯರ್ಲಿ ಇನ್ ಟು ದ ಬ್ರಾಕೆಟ್. ವಾಟ್ ಇಫ್ ನೋ ಇನ್ಫಾರ್ಮೇಶನ್ ಇಸ್ ಗಿವನ್? ಎವ್ರಿ ಟೈಮ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಅಲಾಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಸೆಲ್ಫ್ ಯು ಶುಡ್ ಶೋ ದ ಪ್ರೀಮಿಯಂ ಆರ್ ಡಿಸ್ಕೌಂಟ್ ವಾಟ್ ಎವರ್ ಇಟ್ ಮೇ ಬಿ. ಓಕೆ, ಲೆಟ್ ಅಸ್ ಗೋ ಅಹೆಡ್. ಎ ಶೇರ್ ಹೋಲ್ಡರ್ ಹೋಲ್ಡಿಂಗ್ 200 ಶೇರ್ಸ್ ಡಿಡ್ ನಾಟ್ ಪೇ ಫೈನಲ್ ಕಾಲ್. ಓಕೆ, ಒನ್ ಶೇರ್ ಹೋಲ್ಡರ್ ಹೂ ಇಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾವಿಂಗ್ 200 ಶೇರ್ಸ್, he was unable to pay this final call only. It means what? He managed to pay the application, allotment as well as the first call. Only final call he was unable to pay. His shares were forfeited. Now his shares has been cancelled. Out of these, only 150 shares were reissued. See, this is again another kind of adjustment. 200 shares galannu you cancel madiri, forfeit madiri. But are you reissuing all the 200 forfeited shares? Again, the answer is no. Out of the 200 forfeited shares, only 150 shares are being issued. So here you should take into consideration the adjustment related to share forfeiture. Idar bagge na ella day 17 of the video dalli heleni. So kindly revisit day 17. What notes are given, see the first slide, 5 notes have been given, points have been given. In that the last point what was there, it relates to this chapter number, question number 13. Okay. Now, out of these 150 shares were reissued to Miss Sonia at rupees 75 per share. Understand this again. 100 rupee iruvanta face value iruvanta share ye, you Miss Sonia ki kodbekadre eshtu rupees ki kottaru, only 75 rupees. Okay. So here again there is a loss on the reissue. Okay, so what we have to do, give the journal entries in the books of the company. So can you tell me how many journal entries will come? First of all, 8 regular journal entries will come. What are these 8 journal entries? Application money received, application money transferred, allotment due along with the discount, then allotment received, then first call due, first call received, final call due, final call received with arrears. After that, 3 journal entries will come. First one will be the forfeiture, second will be the reissue, and the third one will be for the balance transferring into the capital reserve of share forfeiture. Okay, so let us start with our first journal entry, which is for application money received. This is the very very easy chapter. And on this chapter, you have complete corporate accounts seen. So you have to be very very clear with these kind of chapters. Now you maximum jobs in corporate dalina ado. Okay. Take down the first journal entry, bank account debit 2. application account. They have clearly told that here equity shares are being issued. Okay, now do the calculation. How many shares are issued? 10,000 shares. 10,000 shares into rupees. What is the amount that is being received? It is rupees 20 per share. So what is the amount that is received? See, it is rupees 2 lakh. Show the amount. 2 lakh. 2 lakh. Narration for Bidri. Being application money. Being application money received. Being application money received on 10,000 shares. Okay. Now, as soon as you do the journal entry for received, what is the next entry that you need to do? It is transfer. So write down equity share application account debit, equity share application account debit to equity share capital account. Equity share capital account. Okay, what is the amount? Amount is rupees 2 lakh. 2 lakh. Okay, give the narration. Being application money, being application money transferred to capital account. To capital account. Okay, now what will be the next journal entry? The next entry will be for the allotment money due. Please remember, in this allotment only we need to show the discount also. Okay, so write down equity share allotment account debit into bracket. How many shares are there? See, 10,000 equity shares are there. So 10,000 shares into rupees. Now, how much you can charge on allotment? Only rupees 30 and not 40. Okay, so rupees 30 each. Then there is a discount. So this is our capital loss. And Niyam New Kaltin Road, you have learned all the rules. Debit the expenses and losses. And this is a capital loss. Okay, so write down discount on issue of shares. Discount on issue of shares account into bracket. How many shares are there? 10,000 shares are there. What is the discount you are giving per share? It is rupees 10 each. Okay, so see, show the calculation. What is the amount that is due? It is rupees 3 lakh. What is the capital loss being incurred? It is rupees 1 lakh. Where this amount will be shown altogether? Into your equity share capital account. Equity share capital account. Okay, so 10,000 shares into rupees 40 each. So what will become the amount that is credited into the capital account? It is equal to rupees 4 lakh. Give the narration. Being allotment money with discount. Allotment money with discount due. Okay. Next, what is the entry? Duly received. Yesterday, dudu bediri, yalla amount bandaiti. Okay? So write down bank account debit into bracket 10,000 shares into rupees 30 each. Now see, how much money was demanded? 30 rupees only was demanded. 40 was not demanded. 10 is the discount which you have given. So the shareholder won't pay that 10 rupees. Okay. So how much has been received? 3 lakh has been received. On what you have received this amount? On equity share allotment account. So write down 2 equity share allotment account. Okay. Amount is rupees 3 lakh. Give the narration. Being allotment money, being allotment money duly received. How much was due? Everything has been received. Allotment money duly received. Okay. Now, what is the next journal entry after this? The first call is due. Okay. So write down equity share. Equity share, first call account debit, first call account debit to equity share capital account, equity share capital account. Into bracket show the calculation, how many shares are there? 10,000 shares are there. On per share, on each share, how much rupee you are demanding? Rupees 30 is being demanded. So rupees 30 each, which is equal to rupees 3 lakh 3. Show the narration. Being first call due, being first call due, this much is enough. Now after due, what will be the next entry? Received. Now see here, whatever is due, it has been completely received, so no problem. Write down bank account debit to equity share first call account, first call account. What is the amount that is received? See, it is rupees 3 lakh. Give the narration. Being first call duly received. First call duly received. So what the word duly says? It says that there are no calls in advance. Okay. In the same way, now we will make the call for the final call. Journal entry number 7. Okay, what it is for? The equity final call due. So final call account debit. Into bracket 10,000 shares into rupees 10 each. Okay, so what is the amount that is due? See, it is merely 1 lakh rupees. Amount should be credited into the equity share capital account. Equity share capital account. Amount is rupees 1 lakh. Okay. Give the narration. Being final call due. Okay. Being final call. Now, show the next entry. When there are calls in arrears, then only forfeiture entry will come. Calls in arrears are again the forfeiture journal entries will not be. So, in the next shareholder, who has 200 shares, they will not be able to get the call. Okay? So, write down bank account debit. On how many shares the amount is received? On 9,800 shares into rupees 10 each. So which is equal to rupees 98,000. Okay. There are calls in arrears. On how many shares? On 200 shares into rupees. which is equal to rupees 2000. So write down 2. Here write down please equity share. Okay. So write down 2. Equity share final call account. And what is the amount? See, amount is rupees 1 lakh. Give the narration. Being final call received, final call received, except on 200 shares. Okay, so ಇಲ್ಲಿ ನಿಮಗೆ ನ್ಯಾರೇಷನ್ ನಲ್ಲಿ ವ್ಯತ್ಯಾಸ ಗೊತ್ತಾಗ್ಬೇಕು ನೋಡ್ರಿ. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಡ್ಯೂಲಿ ರಿಸೀವ್ಡ್ ಹೇಳಿರೋ ಮೀನಿಂಗ್ ಏನಾಯ್ತು, ಎಲ್ಲ ಬಂತು, ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಎಲ್ಲ ಬಂದಿಲ್ಲ ಅಂತಾನೆ ಏನ್ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರಿ, ಬೀಯಿಂಗ್ ಫೈನಲ್ ಕಾಲ್ ರಿಸೀವ್ಡ್ ಎಕ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್ ಆನ್ 200 ಶೇರ್ಸ್. ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್. ಈಗ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಮೂರು ಜರ್ನಲ್ ಎಂಟ್ರೀಸ್ ಎದರ ಮೇಲೆ ಸಂಬಂಧಿಸದವು, ದೇ ಆರ್ ರಿಲೇಟೆಡ್ ಆನ್ ಫಾರ್ ಫ್ಯೂಚರ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಲೆಟ್ ಅಸ್ ಡೂ ದ ಜರ್ನಲ್ ಎಂಟ್ರೀಸ್ ರಿಲೇಟೆಡ್ ಟು ದ ಫಾರ್ ಫ್ಯೂಚರ್ ಆಫ್ ಶೇರ್ಸ್. Journal entry number 9. What it is, first of all, cancellation. So equity share capital in you ain't half bay notary, debit half bay. Okay, so write down equity share capital account debit. Okay, into bracket, how many shares are being forfeited? 200 shares. Into rupees, my dear children, please remember, you have to show the forfeiture journal entry for the full face value of the share. So what is the face value here? It is rupees 100 each. Okay, so what is the amount? See, amount is equal to rupees 20,000. Okay, ಈಗ ಮತ್ತೊಮ್ಮೆ ನೆನಪಿಡ್ರಿ, ದಟ್ ನ್ಯೂ ಶೇರ್ಸ್ ಯಾವ ರೀತಿ ಇಶ್ಯೂ ಮಾಡಿರಿ, ಅಟ್ ಪಾರ್ ಇಶ್ಯೂ ಮಾಡಿರಿ, ಅಟ್ ಪ್ರೀಮಿಯಂ ಇಶ್ಯೂ ಮಾಡಿರಿ. ಯಾವಾಗ ಪ್ರೀಮಿಯಂ ಅಂತ ಬಂತು ಮತ್ತೆ ಅದ್ರಾಗ ಎರಡು ಪ್ರಕಾರ ಅದಾವು, ವೆದರ್ ದ ಪ್ರೀಮಿಯಂ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ರಿಸೀವ್ಡ್ ಆರ್ ನಾಟ್ ರಿಸೀವ್ಡ್, ಅಂಡ್ ಇಫ್ ದ ಶೇರ್ಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಬಿನ್ ಇಶ್ಯೂಡ್ ಅಟ್ ಡಿಸ್ಕೌಂಟ್. ಸೊ ಲೈಕ್ ದಿಸ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಫೋರ್ ಟೈಪ್ಸ್. ಕೈಂಡ್ಲಿ ವಾಚ್ ಡೇ 17 ವಿಡಿಯೋ ಫಾರ್ ದಿಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಟೈಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್? ದ ಶೇರ್ಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಬಿನ್ ಇಶ್ಯೂಡ್ ಅಟ್ ಅ ಡಿಸ್ಕೌಂಟ್. ಸೊ 800 ಶೇರ್ಸ್ ಮೇಲೆ ನಿಮಗೆ ಡಿಸ್ಕೌಂಟ್ ಲಾಸ್ ಅಂತ ನೀವು ತೋರಿಸಿರಿ, ಅದನ್ನು ನೀವು ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು, ಕ್ಯಾನ್ಸಲ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು ಡ್ಯೂರಿಂಗ್ ದ ಫಾರ್ ಫ್ಯೂಚರ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ಸಲ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ನೀವು ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಡೆಬಿಟ್ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ರಿ ನೋಡ್ರಿ ಮೂರನೇ ಎಂಟ್ರಿದಲ್ಲಿ. ಸೊ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಏನ್ ಕೊಡಬೇಕು? ಕ್ರೆಡಿಟ್ ಅನ್ನು ಕೊಡಬೇಕು. ಬಟ್ ಪೂರ್ಣ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಕೊಡ್ತೀರಿ? ನೋ, ಓನ್ಲಿ ಫಾರ್ ದ ಶೇರ್ಸ್ ದಟ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಫಾರ್ಫಿಟಿಂಗ್ ರೈಟ್ ನೌ. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ರೈಟ್ ಡೌನ್ 2, ಡಿಸ್ಕೌಂಟ್ ಆನ್ ಇಶ್ಯೂ ಆಫ್ ಶೇರ್ಸ್, ಡಿಸ್ಕೌಂಟ್ ಆನ್ ಇಶ್ಯೂ ಆಫ್ ಶೇರ್ಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಇಂಟು ಬ್ರಾಕೆಟ್ ಹೌ ಮೆನಿ ಶೇರ್ಸ್? 200 ಶೇರ್ಸ್. Into what was the discount that was initially given? It was rupees 10 each. So what is the amount that we have cancelled? See, it is rupees 2000. Okay. Now, 2, share forfeiture account. Now, in share forfeiture account, what you will show? The amount that has been paid so far by this shareholder. Okay, innu tanka ಈ ಶೇರ್ ಹೋಲ್ಡರ್ ಏನ್ ದುಡ್ಡವನ್ನು ತುಂಬ್ಯಾನು ಅದನ್ನ ನೀವು ಈ ಶೇರ್ ಫಾರ್ ಫ್ಯೂಚರ್ ಅಕೌಂಟ್ ನಲ್ಲಿ ತೋರಿಸಬೇಕು. ಸೊ ಆಸ್ ವಿ ನೋ, ದಿಸ್ ಶೇರ್ ಹೋಲ್ಡರ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಪೇಡ್ ಅಪ್ಲಿಕೇಶನ್ ಮನಿ, ಅಲಾಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಮನಿ, ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಕಾಲ್ ಮನಿ. ವಾಟ್ ಹಿ ವಾಸ್ ಅನೇಬಲ್ ಟು ಪೇ? ಓನ್ಲಿ ದ ಫೈನಲ್ ಕಾಲ್. ಸೊ ಅಪ್ಲಿಕೇಶನ್ ಮೇಲಿನೂ 20, ಅಲಾಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಮೇಲಿನೂ 30, ಮತ್ತು ಮೊದಲನೇ ಕಾಲ್ ಮೇಲಿನೂ 30 ರೂಪಾಯಿ. ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಟೋಟಲ್ ಎಷ್ಟು ದುಡ್ಡು ತುಂಬ್ಯಾರು ನೋಡ್ರಿ? 80 ರುಪೀಸ್ ಪರ್ ಶೇರ್ ತುಂಬೈತಿ. ಸೊ ರುಪೀಸ್ 80 ಈಚ್. So what is the amount that has been collected by this shareholder so far? It is rupees 16,000. So this 16,000 amount which was received from this shareholder will be transferred into share for future account. Next, what you will put here, a credit. What you have given a debit over here in calls in arrears, that will be credited over here. Why credited? ಇನ್ನು ಮುಂದೆ ನೀವು ಅವ್ರ ಕಡೆ ಬೇಡಂಗನ ಇಲ್ಲ. ವೈ? ಎದಕ್ಕೆ ಬಿಡಂಗಿಲ್ಲ, ಇನ್ ಮುಂದೆ ಅವ್ರು ನಿಮ್ ಶೇರ್ ಹೋಲ್ಡರ್ನೇ ಇಲ್ಲ. ಅಂಡ್ ದೇರ್ ಫೋರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಡೆಬಿಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಟು ಬಿ ರಿಮೂವ್ಡ್. ಯು ಕೆನಾಟ್ ಶೋ ಇನ್ ಟು ಯುವರ್ ಬ್ಯಾಲೆನ್ಸ್ ಶೀಟ್ ದಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಮಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಯುವರ್ ಔಟ್ ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಟು ಬಿ ರಿಸೀವ್ಡ್. ಅಂಡ್ ದೇರ್ ಫೋರ್ ದಟ್ ನೀಡ್ಸ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ಸಲ್ಡ್. ಅಂಡ್ ಟು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ಸಲ್ ಅ ಡೆಬಿಟ್ ವಾಟ್ ವಿ ಶುಡ್ ಪುಟ್, ವಿ ಶುಡ್ ಪುಟ್ ಅ ಕ್ರೆಡಿಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಸೇಮ್ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಫಾರ್ ದ ಸೇಮ್ ಅಕೌಂಟ್. ಅಂಡ್ ದೇರ್ ಫೋರ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಪುಟಿಂಗ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಕಾಲ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಅರಿಯರ್ಸ್ ಅಕೌಂಟ್ for rupees 2000. So in this way your debit should and must become equal to your credit. See, your debit is for 20,000 and your credit is also becoming for 20,000. So nenapirli, whenever the discount is there into the question, at the time of forfeiture it should and must be credited for the number of shares that you have forfeited. If you do not do this, your journal entry won't tally. And then you will be into confusion into the examination hall. Yen aithal. Okay? So yes. Shall we write down the narration? Write down being 200 shares forfeited. Okay? Ee nantaro aitu cancellation. Now what we need to do next? We need to reissue. Okay? So did the company reissue the shares? Yes, the company reissued the shares. For how much? The company has reissued to Miss Sonia at ₹75 per share. Okay. So here should I consider the difference amount of 25 as a discount? No. This is the loss on reissue. Okay. So ili bank account ili debit hakbidri. Okay. Yes. Another one important. ಏನ್ ಹೇಳ್ಯಾರ ನೋಡ್ರಿ ಈ ಲೆಕ್ಕದಲ್ಲಿ, ಔಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದೀಸ್ 200 ಶೇರ್ಸ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ 150 ಆರ್ ರೀಇಶ್ಯೂಡ್. ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಅಡ್ಜಸ್ಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್ ಸಿ. ಸೊ ಓನ್ಲಿ 150 ಶೇರ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ರೀಇಶ್ಯೂಡ್ ಅಟ್ ವಾಟ್ ಪ್ರೈಸ್? ಅಟ್ ₹75. ಪ್ಲೀಸ್ ಈ ಎಂಟ್ರಿಗೆ ಎಲ್ಲರೂ ಲಕ್ಷ ಕೊಟ್ಟು ನೋಡ್ರಿ, ಕ್ಯೂಕೋರಿ. ಓಕೆ, ಇಲ್ಲಿ ನಾ ಎರಡು ಗೆರಿ ಅಥವಾ ಒಂದು ಗೆರಿ ಬಿಡ್ತೀನಿ ನೋಡ್ರಿ. ಟೂ ಇಕ್ವಿಟಿ ಶೇರ್ ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲ್ ಅಕೌಂಟಿಗೆ ಕ್ರೆಡಿಟ್ ಕೊಡಕತ್ತೀನಿ. ನಾವ್ ಇನ್ ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲ್ ಅಕೌಂಟ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಶೋ ದ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಫಾರ್ ದ ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಶೇರ್ಸ್ ಇಶ್ಯೂಡ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ, ನಾಟ್ ಫಾರ್ ದ ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಶೇರ್ಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ಆರ್ ಫಾರ್ಫೀಟೆಡ್. ಓಕೆ, ಎಷ್ಟು ನೀವು ಮಾರ್ಕೆಟ್ ದಾಗ ಇಶ್ಯೂ ಮಾಡ್ತೀರಿ ಅಷ್ಟ ದುಡ್ಡು ಜಮಾ ಆಗ್ತೈತಿ. ಸೊ 150 ಶೇರ್ಸ್ ಗೆ ನೀವು ಇಶ್ಯೂ ಮಾಡಿರಿ, ಬಟ್ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಯಾವ ತೋರಿಸ್ತೀರಿ? ಫೇಸ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂನ, ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ₹100 ಈಚ್. So therefore, what is the amount? It is ₹15,000. Okay. ಈಗ ನಿಮಗೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಏನಾಗೈತಿ, ನುಕ್ಸಾನ್ ಆಗೈತಿ. ಶೇರ್ಸ್ಗಳನ್ನು ರೀಇಶ್ಯೂ ಮಾಡಬೇಕಾಗ, ₹100 ಶೇರ್ ನೀವು ₹75 ಇಶ್ಯೂ ಮಾಡಕತ್ತೀರಂದ್ರೆ ₹25 ನಿಮಗೆ ಏನಾಯ್ತು, ನುಕ್ಸಾನ್ ಆಯ್ತು ಆನ್ ರೀಇಶ್ಯೂ. ಇಟ್ಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಡಿಸ್ಕೌಂಟ್. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಲಾಸ್ ಆನ್ ರೀಇಶ್ಯೂ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಕವರ್ಡ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದಿಸ್ ಶೇರ್ ಫಾರ್ ಫ್ಯೂಚರ್ ಅಕೌಂಟ್. ಸೊ ರೈಟ್ ಡೌನ್ ಹಿಯರ್, ಶೇರ್ ಫಾರ್ ಫ್ಯೂಚರ್ account into bracket on 150 shares into ₹25 each. Okay, so what is the loss on reissue of shares? It is ₹3,750. So obviously, what is the amount that is being received? See, okay. So show that amount. Okay, ₹11,250 is the amount that is being received. Okay. Yes, correct. Show the narration. Being 150 forfeited shares reissued at ₹75 each as fully paid. fully paid. Now here it has to be taken at rupees 15. Why 15? Because your shares are already at discount. That's why. So 150 shares into rupees 15 each. Okay. So that will become 2250. Okay. Kindly please rectify this mistake. The earlier entry was correct. Okay. Yes. Being 150 forfeited shares, we issued at rupees 75 each as fully paid. Okay. Now we have to do the last journal entry. What is this last journal entry? For transferring the balance into share forfeiture account. Journal entry number 11. So, write down the journal entry first. What it is? Share forfeiture account debit. Share forfeiture account debit into bracket. Yes, to go to Jara, I noted share forfeiture account only. Now, here is the major adjustment again. See, this question is full of adjustments. So, if you do not have the clear clarity of the concept, you will get confused. In share forfeiture account, how much amount has been credited? See, on 200 shares, rupees 80. But are we reissuing all the 200 shares? No, we are issuing only 150 shares. And therefore, we should take into consideration only the 150 shares share forfeiture account that was there with them. Okay. So on 150 shares into rupees 80 each. So what is the amount related to 150 shares? 12,000. Okay. So in that we will reduce the loss that has been incurred. Okay. So that is rupees 25 on 150 shares, which is equal to rupees 3,750. Okay, so from 12,000 we are going to recover the loss, and whatever balance is there, it will be transferred to capital reserve account. Okay, so do the calculation. From 12,000, okay, from 12,000 subtract 3,750. So what will be the balance? It will be 8,250 rupees. Okay. So 8,250 rupees is transferred. Here the narration needs to be very, very clear to give the explanation about that. So write down, being balance on 150 forfeited shares in share forfeiture account. In share forfeiture account, transferred to capital reserve account. Transferred to capital reserve account. Okay. So yes, with this we have come to the end of today's class. What we have covered, see, we have covered question number 12 and 13 from your textbook page number 69. Okay. So as we will move ahead, the quality of sums will become yet tougher and tougher. Okay. So all of you kindly practice daily. Today onwards there is no homework because your question bank itself is your complete homework. Okay. So I hope all of you are understanding my classes. We shall continue tomorrow.